Wisdom shines in talks with Sri Ramana Maharshi. My comments bring this profound wisdom into your experience. Use YouTube's closed captions to read along.
Finally, Ramana lays out the practice of discrimination within self-inquiry and breaks it into three stages. This is the stage of reflected reality, where you're starting to see the world as unreal. This is probably where most seekers are, on the path and developing their self-knowledge into deeper views. Ramana says, again, reality is used in a different sense and applies loosely by some thinkers to objects. They say that the reflected reality admits of degrees which are named everyday life. The chair is seen by me and real. An illusory reality, the illusion of a serpent in a coiled rope. An ultimate reality, reality is that which remains the same always and without change. If reality be used in the wider sense, the world may be said to have the everyday life and illusory degrees. Some, however, deny even the reality of practical life, everyday life, and consider it only to be a projection of the mind. According to them, it's only an illusion. For those on the path, your experience may be a mixture of these three elements: everyday life with its seeming reality, and seeing the world as illusion and unreal, and also experiencing and knowing of this reality which is always here and stays the same, which is always real. When this process ripens, then, as Ramana tells us, there is only being in self-realization, and nothing but being. And that being consciousness is who we are. It's our very existence. We're told this again and again. It must be experienced and known directly, not just known by the mind. What do you consider yourself to be? It is this development of your view of yourself and the world that makes up practice. It starts with the world is real, then progresses to the world is unreal, and then progresses to there is only reality, and I am that. What do you consider yourself to be? When I was thinking about this, I remembered a song from Donovan in 1967. It had the refrain, "First there is a mountain, then there is no mountain, then there is." I have queued up a video of that so we can remember Donovan's words in the hippie day.
Last night, the up on my garden gates, a snail, that's what it is. Lock up on my garden gates, a snail, that's what it is. First there is a mountain, then there is no mountain, then there is. First there is a mountain, then there is no mountain, then there is. Caterpillar sheds his skin to find a butterfly within. Caterpillar sheds his skin to find a butterfly within. First there is a mountain, then there is no mountain, then there is. First there is a mountain, then there is no mountain. Oh, Juanita. Oh, Juanita.
Oh, Juanita.
I call your name. Oh, the snow will be a blinding sight to see as it lies on yonder hillside. Lock up on my garden gates, a snail, that's what it is. Lock up on my garden gates, a snail, that's what it is. Caterpillar sheds its skin to find a butterfly within. Caterpillar shed his skin to find the butterfly within. First there is a mountain, then there is no mountain, then there is. First there is a mountain, then there is no mountain, then there is. First there is a mountain, then there is. Mountain, then there is. First there is a mountain, then there is no mountain.
Now, when I was researching this song, I found out about the history. First, though, I want to say this is a joyful song and a song about transformation. He says, the caterpillar sheds his skin to find a butterfly within. Ramana tells us something higher, though. Ramana says no transformation is needed, since this is always who we have been. We don't have to change to something we're not. We just have to be who we are. It turns out, as I researched this song, I found it was based on an ancient Chan teaching during the Tang Dynasty from 618 to 907. This period was known as a high point in Chinese civilization and was also the time when Chan Buddhism was introduced and spread in China. During this time, the Chan master Kuan Yin Wei Jing wrote, quote, before I had studied Chan for 30 years, I saw mountains and mountains and rivers as rivers. When I arrived to more intimate knowledge, I came to the point where I saw that mountains are not mountains, and rivers are not rivers. But now that I have gotten its very substance, I am at rest. For it's just that I see mountains once again as mountains, and rivers once again as rivers. Now, I love it when I find these teachings from different sources separated by 1,000 years, where they're still saying the same thing, even though they arrived at it to a different path. To me, this is very encouraging.
These videos help bring Ramana Maharshi's teachings into your direct experience. Subscribe now to help you deepen your understanding and practice to know the self. Just click the subscribe button.